Hello children, good morning to you all. Yesterday we have finished teaching the lesson, complete lesson explanation over, but only one thing I have to teach you, that is uses of Himalayas for India. Uses of, how are the Himalayan mountains useful to us? Or so how are the Himalayan mountains important for us? So uses kanna importance of the Himalayan mountains we have to know. How are the Himalayan mountains important for us? Importance of the Himalayan mountains. Importance of the Himalayan mountains. How are these Himalayan mountains important for us? Understand? You all know they are located in the three ranges to the north and the northwestern side of our country. They are like big walls. Understand? They protect us from cold waves blowing from the North Pole, which is covered with full of ice. Okay, so this is one important thing about Himalayas. Himalayas stop the cold waves blowing from the north. Second thing, they guard our country. First thing, they Himalayas, first let me mention, Himalayas stop the cold waves, cold winds, waves come blowing from the north. They stop the very cold, coldest waves. Only in winter season we can't bear. But more than that coldness, these cold waves are very horrible. We can't even withstand them. Understand? So such cold waves, Himalayan mountains stop from blowing, which blow from the north. And they protect us from extremely cold climate. Second thing, they guard our northern north border. They guard our northern border. They guard our northern border. They guard our northern border. Okay. They guard our northern border means it stands like the watchman. Does the watchman allow you to get into others' house, strangers inside? No. He will inquire. He will stop you outside if he gets any doubt. Same way, the Himalayan mountains guard our northern border. Means they don't allow the enemies to enter our country. They protect us from the enemies entering from the north side. Third, passes and gaps between the mountains help the people to cross the mountain ranges. Passes. What are passes? Passes means the narrow path over through the between the or the narrow path, way to cross the mountain ranges is called passes. Gaps. There is a gap between, see, do you see the gap between my two hands, two palms? So there is a gap between two mountain ranges which helps them to cross or pass them. they protect us from very cold winds, I told. They check the monsoon coming from the south and cause heavy rainfall. Understand? From the south. We have, for example, we have Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean. Three sides, luckily we have water bodies. Understand? What happens, you know, when the sunset falls on these water bodies, water gets evaporated and means water changes into water form and form into the clouds. These clouds pass over here in the country. So these mountains, Himalayan mountains, stop these check the mountains, means they stop the mountains from crossing our country. Because Himalayan mountains are there, they don't cross the country. They stop them and cause rainfall in our country. The next point is, these Himalayan mountains are covered with snow, children. So, because of that snow, you can find glaciers, many glaciers in these mountains. Means, we have slow moving mass of ice or slow moving river of ice glacier. Where do you find them? Only in the Himalayan mountains. And they provide water to the big rivers of our country like Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, Satluj. These are very big rivers in our country. And they make them perennial rivers. Perennial means, perennial rivers are those rivers which will not dry up all through the year. Whole year you find water in these rivers. Understand? So, these Himalayas, snow in the Himalayas, provide water to our rivers of North India. And as there is water in the rivers, where from these rivers get? From the Himalayan snow. This water is very useful to grow crops in the farms. And because of this water facility, and as the Himalayas stop rains, clouds, they check the monsoon wind and cause rain, we find in the eastern part of India or on the slopes of the Himalayan mountain, some thick forests. And they provide timber, herbs, so many useful trees. And because of these forests, which are grown due to on the slopes of the Himalayas, you find many wildlife, varieties of wildlife in this forest. Means you can find even the wildlife sanctuaries also in this Himalayan region. These are the uses of the Himalayan mountains. They check the cold winds and protect us from the extremely cold weather. They guard our northern border. They check the monsoon winds and cause rainfall. They provide water to many of the rivers of North India, making them the perennial rivers. They provide water for the farms. They are the home of thick forests and wildlife. These are the uses of Himalayan mountains. Now, let us go to the next point. This is what I wanted to teach you. Now, our next is, we will go to the notes part today. I am going to give you, few define the following or meaning type things. Today we will start our notes with define the following. Define the following. first one in that. Posts or poles supporting a house, are called tilt. Posts means long tree trunks. Stilt posts or poles supporting a house are called stilt. Orchard. Orchards. A plant with a plant with complex flowers, colorful flowers, a plant with colorful flowers, plants with colorful flowers that are used for decoration, which are used for decoration, are called orchards. Is called an orchard. What is an orchard? A plant with colorful flowers that are used for decoration is called an orchard. What is stilt? Posts or poles supporting a house are called stilt. These two are over. I have to rub the board because space is not there. Let us go to third one. Glacier. River of ice that flows slowly is called a glacier. River of ice that flows slowly is called a, or that moves slowly. What is a glacier? A river of ice that moves slowly is called a glacier. Valleys. Low areas surrounded by hills low areas surrounded by hills, surrounded by hills or mountains. Are called valleys. What are valleys? Low areas surrounded by hills or mountains are called valleys. What are valleys? Low areas surrounded by hills or mountains are called valleys. Next. Pass. A narrow path over or through the mountains. The mountain is called pass. It's called a pass. A narrow path over or through the mountain is called pass. What is pass? A narrow path over or through the mountain is called a pass. Once again, let us read all the three. First one, glacier. River of ice that moves slowly is called a glacier. River of ice that moves slowly is called a glacier. Valleys, low areas surrounded by hills or mountains are called valleys. Low areas surrounded by hills and mountains are called valleys. Pass, a narrow path over or through the main mountain, is called pass. A narrow path over or through the mountain is called a pass. Next. Sixth one, orchard. Orchard, a place where fruits are grown. A place where fruits are grown. Is called an orchard. A place where fruits are grown is called an orchard. What is an orchard? A place where fruits are grown is called an orchard. Last one in this is perennial rivers. Perennial rivers. The rivers down I take. The rivers that flow throughout the year and never dry up. Are called perennial rivers. Okay, perennial rivers. The rivers that flow throughout the year. I never dry up are called perennial rivers. What are perennial rivers? The rivers that flow throughout the year and never dry up are called perennial rivers. Orchard means a place where fruits are grown is called an orchard. Perennial rivers, the rivers that flow throughout the year and never dry up are called perennial rivers. So these are the definitions. Define the following you have got, and I explained you how the Himalayan mountains are useful. So here we stop, children. Thank you, and I will send a notes part. Please copy them in your notebook. Leave one line between two definitions. That's it. Thank you.